First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intentions straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
Peace. We back once again. And tonight's discussion is going to be on alternative healing, Reiki, Pranayama, which is pranic healing, the moderate version, Qigong, Tai Chi, etc. What we're going to do first is start with the science of the mind. Because as we said last week, it's only there in which that you will find a cure for all diseases. The mind must be corrected. The link between the conscious and the subconscious mind or unconscious mind must be reestablished. It was there before puberty. However, after puberty, that connection dwindled and became more interrupted by other people's programming. Therefore, you must reprogram your mind. Your thoughts, your philosophies must change. We all do. In Judaism and Christianity, they do their various prayers 3 times daily. At least Christians are supposed to. In Islam, they do what is called chanting or dhikring. The 99 names are attributes of Allah. Approximately 500 times a day. During each prayer, which they're supposed to pray 5 times a day, during each setting, they say the 99 names of Allah. Sufis do it 1,000 times daily, if not more, because to them, every thought is a prayer to Allah, God, which resides within them. The Buddhists chant, Nama Yoho Rengekyo, thousands of times a day. So each religious system has a science of correcting the mind, bringing the mind back into focus and concentration. Because truly, these prayers, affirmations, decrees, hesis, or hakahus, words of power, sounds, a vibratory change are done in order to bring the mind, the mental, into balance. The role of religion originally meant, according to the Latin word religo, which the word religion is derived from, means to bind or link back. It's the same within the Sanskrit teachings of yoga, oftentimes called yoga, which means to bring about a union, which this concept is from Samatawi, which is the ancient Kemetic or Tamarian concept of tying the lower self and the higher self, unifying the lower self aspects into the higher self so that there is only one self. This is what the role of religion originally was. It was to teach man about his and her God self, i.e. the power of the mind, how to use its attractive magnetic qualities. This is how you are made in the image and after the likeness of God. It's talking about your mind. Your mind is what produces those images and those likenesses, or what is called the reflections, in which that you can bring forth your reality, your destiny, manifest that which that you want from the astral, ethereal plane into the physical. So when we get into Reiki, the word Reiki means universal life force energy. This universal life force energy is derived, the name Reiki is derived from the ancient Tamarian or Tamarian name of Ra-Ka. We know who Ra is according to the Tamarian, Kemetic, ancient Egyptian philosophy. Ra is photonic energy, the all-pervading energy of the universe. This universal life force energy, this is Ra. His counterpart, feminine aspect, is Rayet. They soon become known as Amen, Amun, and Amenet, or Amenta. Hence the reason why at the end of the three monotheistic belief systems, Christianity, Judaism, and Islam, they all say Amen at the end of their prayers. They are calling on this hidden, unseen force that pervades the universe, that formed the universe, that formed you into the very existence, from the unseen into the seen, from the intangible into the tangible. We should know by now that just because we can't see it doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. We can't see the wind either. However, we know when it blows on us that it is a force, a power to be reckoned with. Well, this prana or chi or ki, or what is also referred to as the kahuna, mana, Holy Spirit within Christianity, it is Ra. This is also the raw, unadulterated force of nature, of the netters. So, Ra, Ka, Ka is spirit. You oftentimes see Ra with the form of Heru, with the sun in a disc above the head, which is symbolic to when you receive your disc above your head, which is the halo, once you have mastered what you need to master here upon planet Earth, and once you are outright righteous, once again you receive this halo, this sun disc called Atun, around your head, for now you have attuned yourself to the supreme forces of the universe. Ka is often seen as the Matunet or the hieroglyph, as two hands being raised at a 90-degree perpendicular level. Hence, even within the Freemasonry, which is the Osirian resurrection, that is also symbolic to spiritual resurrection. The Kundalini, which is the Osirian force resurrecting Osir, which is the soul embedded inside of the pineal gland. Osir rests, or is half asleep, wrapped 3.5 times coil at the base of the spine. When she is awakened, this queen of heaven, this mother force, this mother goddess energy, this black goddess, the Madonna, she is awakened, and she raised up through those various chambers, or the 7 openings, or what is referred to as the 7 souls of Ra, also referred to as the 7 churches, 7 chakras. At the 7th chakra and the last chakra, she activates and awakens her mate, Osir. This is the divine marriage in heaven, and from this union comes forth Heru, the incarnation of Osir, which is higher consciousness, the higher self, the God self, the Christ consciousness. Raka, or Reiki, is your body attuning itself to the universal energies and bringing those energies into your body, being a channel to be transmitted outward through via your head to your heart, via your arms and your hands, into an individual, into yourself or into someone else. This is the science of Reiki. It's a hands-on healing technique, and there are 4 symbols that is traditionally used. There's many symbols, but 4 traditionally used within each of the various systems of Reiki. In particular, you have Ushi Reiki, which was founded by Mukeo Ushi, who was a Japanese Buddhist traditionally, in which that the 4 symbols on which that he brought forth was Choku Rei, Seiheki, Hanshashi Shonen, and Deko Mio. Choku Rei is the symbol for the physical, for the body. Seiheki is the symbol for the emotional body. Hanshashi Shonen is the symbol for distant healing. It is also the symbol for mental, for the mental body. Deko Mio is the symbol for the spirit body. These 4 work in conjunction in order to alleviate karma through the process of healing. Karma is produced by the things in which that you do as an individual, your thoughts, your deeds, your actions, your behavior is what causes karma. If they are negative, then you have just produced karma. Now, karma is based on the 12 zodiac signs, and as the sun go through 12 of those zodiac signs every 26,000 years approximately. It's actually 25,928 years. And according to Elijah Muhammad, he just referred to it as a 25,000 year renewal of history. Amazingly enough, we are ending a 25,000 year renewal of history. Hence the reason why they say it's the end of the world. As we move towards December the 21st, 2012 AD, and we will be the bearers for this new 25,000 year of history. Our thoughts, as being the bearers, the light bearers, would be the projection, that projected energy for the next 25,000 year renewal of history. This is why all this information is coming out at this particular time, so that we can assess it, analyze it, and accumulate it, so that as our thoughts become the energy field for the next 25,000 years of this planet, in other words, we are here to project, to manifest, to bring things into existence. That's what the mind and body does in unison. Your very thoughts or things . All right, so when you're utilizing Reiki, your thoughts must be purified, and you must be able to concentrate and focus on your objective, and that is the healing process, whether it's for yourself or if it is for others. As you are channeling this energy, this universal life force energy, you are visualizing each of these symbols, and you're saying these symbols three times prior to resting your hand upon the next area of the body. Normally, there's 16 positions . You start at the crown of your head, start at your eyes, side of your face, your throat, your heart, solar plexus, navel, genitals, knees, ankles, feet, your kidneys, small of the back, your shoulders, the back of the throat, and the back of the head, back to the crown. These are the various positions for your hands, as you touch yourself, as well as also as you touch others in this healing process, or what is referred to as Reiki, the universal life force energy. Now, there's three initiations or attunements. You have Reiki 1, Reiki 2, Reiki 3. Very reminiscent to Freemasonry and the Three Degrees. Into apprentice, fellow craftsman, master mason. In Reiki 1, you do not receive any symbols, but you do receive the symbols inside of your aura. What I mean by you do not receive any symbols is that you're not told about the symbols as of yet, normally. Of course, now this information, a lot of it is on the internet and on YouTube, so actually you can already know by doing your own research. So a lot of the practitioners had to change that for Reiki 1. So nowadays, a lot of the symbols, or the symbols themselves, are given in Reiki 1. All right? Even though all four symbols actually are embedded inside of your auric field anyway. Reiki 2, you learn about the symbols of Choku Rei, Seiheki, and Hansha Shishonen. Reiki 3, you learn about Dekomio, the master symbol. For Reiki 1, there's four attunements. Reiki 2, two attunements. Reiki 3, one to four attunements. based on the instructor. So, Reiki is something in which that you definitely need to know in this day and time. Because with these solar flares, mega flares, super flares bombarding the planet Earth, the hospital might be obsolete. And the only thing that you might be able to rely upon is your hands, your mind, channeling that energy into you via your body. Now, when we talk about the mind, let's get into some of the symbolism. Like, for example, a person who have arthritis, the source of that problem, which is the emotional or mental problem, is basically a pattern of criticism of self and others. All right? So an individual with arthritis, they will have to be able to become less critical and ease up on themselves and others. And they will have to begin to start developing some type of positive affirmation or decree for themselves. In which that they would say something similar to, I am the flowing waters of life. Why flowing? Because being that arthritis deals with the hands and different parts of the body being stiffened, you will want to use the word flow, as well as also I am, which is the divine presence, which is another concept for your soul, which is the same as the om sound within the ancient Sanskrit teachings. Cancer is anger, deep resentment, distrust, self-pity, the feeling of hopelessness and helplessness. Wonder why it has increased? Because people feel hopeless and helpless, especially so-called people of color. So, the decree can be something such as, I am worthy, I am love. And these particular sentences, however it's in English, you can also find the ancient Kemetic, or Tumerian, translation, Sumerian translation, however you want to do it, it is up to you. One of the best ways to do it, however, is to record your own voice and play it back while you're asleep. Your voice is the voice in which that your body takes in the easiest as far as when it comes to programming. And as you sleep, it goes directly into the subconscious mind, where it is filtered down into the superconscious, the magnetic conscious, and eventually into the infinite consciousness. Correcting other misprograms in which that has been inserted inside of your mind via your brain. Activating and opening new channels for this electromagnetic energy to flow through. Referred to as your dendrites and your synapses. Your fingers, for example, when you hurt your fingers or when there's something going on with your hand, like, for example, your index finger is your ego, anger, and fear. Your thumb is worry. Your middle finger on the right hand is anger. On the left hand, that's for the woman. In other words, if it's your left hand, it's feminine energy. If it's your right hand, it's masculine energy. And being that that's the middle finger, it deals also with sexual frustration. So what you would do is learn the science of reflexology and acupuncture or acupressure. Your ring finger symbolizes unions and grief. Your pinky finger symbolizes family and pretending. So be aware of these particular hands or fingers on your hands when they are hurt. And it can tell you a lot on what is going on with the situation around you. Your genitals deals with rejection. In particular, rejecting sexuality. The thinking that sex is dirty or that you're going to catch something. When the immune system is healthy, male nor female can catch anything from either, from neither. If you have problems with headaches, it's invalidating yourself. You have problems with the heart. Heart symbolizes love. And the blood is joy. And a heart attack is the denial or squeezing out of what? Love and joy. You have problems with the lungs. Inability to take in or give out life. It's actually a denial of life. Inferiority complex. You see a whole lot of people walking around nowadays with oxygen machines. I've never seen this before 20 years ago, before 10 years ago. So we have to be aware on the power of the mind. And like we said, Reiki helps with correcting karma. The healing energy, which is universal life force energy, helps with correcting karma. So that means if you place your hands on these particular positions, as we went over, from your head to your feet, back to your head again, then actually what you would be doing is a decree or positive affirmation. You are channeling universal energy into those particular areas in which that you might have indirectly or directly embedded these conscious states, these negative thought forms, attach them to your auric field. When negative thought forms are attached into your auric field, it causes leaks and holes. So not only are you doing detriment to yourself, then you have the thoughts of others, which also, remember, thoughts are things. Negative thought forms from others also can attach to your electromagnetic field called your aura and cause leaks and holes. So not only are you weakening your auric field yourself, you have to worry about others attempting to do so too in the process. So these positive affirmations helps with alleviating that karma. These hand positions in Reiki and these particular symbols help with alleviating that karma. We must master this. We must. We have no choice. I hear a lot of people on the Blog Talk radios, and they're not teaching what people really need in this day and time. A lot of stuff is irrelevant. A lot of stuff is ego. The agenda should be the people. The agenda should be about teaching people how to heal themselves. According to the Moorish Holy Quran, Circle 7, it says, we are supposed to teach man about the holy breath. We are supposed to teach man that Allah and man is one. As a Moor, I'm not seeing enough of that from other Moors, whether they're various affiliations or associations. Or organizations, I should say. Now I'm seeing a lot of quoting. And that is good if you're a beginner. You have to memorize. You have to be able to know what is being said and embed it within your heart, within your mind. But once that is done, then you must be able to correlate the information. This is where understanding comes in at. Comprehension comes in at. So you might know, but you still don't have wisdom. Wisdom comes through experience. It's come through practical application. The things in which that we're talking about is application. Knowing is only half the battle. I see too many people running around not knowing that they're even in their lower selves. And no one is perfect. You all have flaws. But the science is to strive upon the path of what is called the Sirat al-Mustaqim, the straight and narrow path. I think it said in the Bible that it's easier for a camel to get through an eye of a needle than it is for a rich man to enter through the gates of heaven. That's the straight and narrow path. This information might not be for everyone, but it should be for everyone. Because this information is what extends your life. This is what gives you the information. This information gives you longevity. This information teaches you about the forces of nature, about how to become a real netter, not just saying that you're God, but yet don't know the science of breath. Don't know the science of pranayama, but you God. Don't understand the forces of nature, but you God. Theoretically, you are God. Practically, you're not. So when we get into the term of Qigong, Qigong translates into breathing and energizing exercises called developing or cultivating energy. The term Nigong translates to internal exercises. The internal exercises are mediums through which the energy is channeled from the atmosphere into the body. And it is stored, as we said before, within the navel, back of the heart, and the third eye to stimulate the body's natural abilities and to replenish the energy depleted through daily living. Check this out. If you fix your eyes on an object for just 1 minute, it would take you 20 minutes of rest to recharge the amount of energy that you lost. One outburst of anger for 1 minute shuts down your whole immune system for 6 hours. and then we watch this programming with the European, with the couples fussing and yelling at each other, and then all of a sudden they got to have makeup sex. Not realizing that the immune system has been shut down. And consequently, that probably would be the easiest time for them to develop some type of illness or disease. Unless they're conscious of their deeds and actions, and they use sex as a healing mechanism, such as Marvin Gaye spoke of, sexual healing, and they know dials of sexology, they know Tantra Kriya Yoga or Tantra Kriya Yoga, according to scientific studies, dying people have been put on a scale and weighed. And at the point of death, there's been recorded a weight loss of about 6 ounces. Thus, it is apparent that this 6 ounces reflects the weight of this vital energy, which is material and is measurable. Now, since energy cannot be destroyed or and just simply transferred or transform, then this is what happens to your vital body after the cutting of the cord, as they would say. The cord is known as the silver cord, according to the book of Ecclesiastes in the Bible. It is also referred to within the occult as the ethereal cord or the etheric cord. When this cord is cut, the vital body ascends. In other words, the electrons of your body with the breath, the spirit, soul, like an egg, leaves the physical body and it ascends into what is called the ionosphere, one of the seven heavens. According to the Quran, the seven heavens. We're on the lowest one, so hence translate to hell. As you go up, according to the Ankh book, which I recommend that y'all get, it states that that the ionosphere is like a mirror, that every reflection in which that is on, that every object that is on planet Earth, it is reflected there in the ionosphere. The Albion knows this. This is why he has his harp system, in order to disrupt the ionosphere. Because this is where our ancestors go once they leave the physical body. And this is why people who are within these various religions, Christianity, Islam, Judaism, look out towards the heavens outside of themselves, because they actually is calling on their ancestors. Subliminally, most of the time not even knowing, but that's what they call on when they're looking outside of themselves. However, they're misdirecting the energy, because it's the God within, in which that, as the scriptures will say, that ye are gods. And do you not know that ye are gods? I think that's in Psalms 82:6, and Matthew 10:34. So our focus should be on the God within. Greater is he within you than he that is in the world. Unto you all things are added. I think the scriptures also say, speak things as if they were. In other words, call a thing into existence. This is all based on what we're talking about. Qigong give you that ability. through these various exercises. The internal exercise direct the innate healing power to specific internal organs and glands to energize the whole or the entire body, balance the energy levels, and promote more effective functions of the internal organs in order to heal, adjust, correct, and above all, prevent disease. In sum, their main purpose is to promote longevity. The first category of internal exercise includes proper or correct sitting, laying, and standing, as well as also walking postures to facilitate healing. You have the 8 standing postures or 8 exercises. Also, I think it's called the 12 zodiac exercises, the 12 nerve exercises, the 3 hugging the tree stances. We practice the Tibetan white crane qigong, 5 animal styles, crane, tiger, dragon, monkey, eagle, and etc. There's a book. Let me see. The name of it is by Stephen Chang. He has one called the Tao of Sexology, which I recommend, and another one called The Complete System of Self-Healing, Internal Exercises. That book is a necessity. Start doing those exercises every day. There's another one by Christopher Kilham. That's K-I-L-H-A-M. And it's called Inner Power. It is necessary to master this. We want to be in alignment when the galactical sun aligns itself with Sirius and our solar system, in particular our sun and the planet Earth. This is what is meant by December 21st, 2012. Everybody got their minds on what's going to happen outside, the disasters. They've been watching the movie 2012 or on the History Channel, Nostradamus 2012 prophecies. All right, this is what is going on. Focus on the inner, and that's what reflects the outer. If we was all doing this, there would be less illness, less poverty, less evil upon the planet Earth. Because it wouldn't be such a negative, crystallized feel around the planet. Our thoughts are just thick, negative feel around the planet. Our thoughts would correct those conditions. Nature's doing it anyway. One of the things in which that has occurred since the 1970s is that the solar winds have destroyed the ozone layer. The ozone layer specifically was a protective, a protection, as we would say, against these incoming forces, such as the solar flares, the corona mass ejection, CMEs, mega and super flares, as they would say. These are the extraterrestrial forces in which that is permeating the atmosphere, creating what is called the greenhouse effect. in which that is a gathering of infrared energy or infrared waves. This infrared waves correlate to the red energy within you at the base of your spine, which is the kundalini. The more energy or infrared energy absorbed within the atmosphere, more there's going to be an upswelling of energy within your spinal column, more of an awakening. This is what has been going on since the 70s. They had us thinking that it's monofluorocarbons in which that destroyed the ozone layer. Aerosol cans. Supposedly, we were spraying our afros and the monofluorocarbons from the aerosol cans depleted the ozone layer. And they still teach this nonsense today. My little nephews were taught this same nonsense today in school. So we really need to look at things and reanalyze ourselves. So that is the first science of internal exercises, or the first category is to learn the proper way of standing, sitting, laying, and walking postures. With a straight spine, the energy can go up uninhibited. The second category includes the 12 major meridians of meditation, in which that you will focus your, once you know the meridian line, you will focus your energy upon the meridians. And you can do that through acupressure, acupuncture, reflexology, massage, as well as stimulate the erogenous zones of the physical body. What this does is adjust, balance, and elevate the energy levels in the body. The mind, body, and spirit are completely integrated. And the individual is completely enlivened with energy. Now, with this energy coming in particular, like we said, from the top of the head, there's certain places in the brain in which that are activated. If you get the book, The Four Gospels, esoterically interpreted by John P. Scott, he states that Christ, which is the soul, is questioned by his disciples, which is the 12 pair of cranial nerves, concerning his identity, to test their spiritual sight and perception. Okay? Peter, as we know, is the one who said that you are the Christ. All right? This requires spiritual sight is gained through regeneration. The word Peter, which is Petro, means a rock in Hebrew. All right? Remember, Jesus said he was going to build his faith upon, his church upon Peter's faith. Peter had built the white stone, which is mentioned in Revelation, the second chapter, the 17th verse, where it states, which it actually is the philosopher's stone. Okay? This white stone is the philosopher's stone, and it's produced by cementing, not calcifying. There is a difference. The 144,000 sand-like magnetic particles of the pineal gland is made hard, like a rock condition, which is actually like a diamond, and is referred to as the Crystal City in Revelation 4:6. As it says, and before the throne there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. The as he's talking about the pineal gland, once the kundalini raises up through the 33 vertebrates, the 31 plus two nerves, 33 nerves, 66 is the reason why the Bible has 66 books in it. And the acronym for the Bible is the basic instructions before leaving Earth. When his energy is drawn up to the pineal gland, this is what happens. As the energy comes up, it first hits from out of the spinal column, the reptilian portion of the brain, which is called the brain stem. Well, according to Layla Africa, in his Nutricide book, he said there's only two sites that are activated in the white Europeans. And he was referring to those in which that is mentioned within African Origin of Biological Psychiatry by Dr. Richie King, that 60 to 80% of those who have that calcified pineal gland, that still leaves 20 to 40% of them that do not, or that can actually reach some type of enlightenment. Here's the reason why Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that there will be some that are left. But here, there's 12 sites, or melanin sites, in the reptilian portion of the brain. Right, you have the locus, the coeruleus. I think it means the black dot. It's also called the mentor neuromelanin tract. This is the area in which that helps you stay conscious or remain conscious while dreaming. This is the area in which that is lucid, even during astral travel and projection. And soul travel. It helps in the process of recalling dreams. A lot of people don't remember their dreams nowadays, or can't recall their dreams. This area is being bombarded with EMF, electromagnetic fields, low EMF. It's being bombarded with electronics. Majority of the electronics oscillates around 60 hertz. For the cells to maintain health, the cells have to oscillate between 70 to 100 hertz. So that means that the electronics are actually pulling the frequency of the cells down. You have the substantia nigra, which means the black substance. The loss of neuromelanin in this area of the brain results in Parkinson's disease, which comes from aluminum accumulation. You have the brachialis. The parnigalis. The intracoponeus. The nerva trigemini. The mason siphis. The pontus centralis. The trigeminty, the parabronchialis, the medullus, dorsal motor, and the retro umbilicus. These are the 12 areas in the reptilian portion of the brain. So when the energy comes up from the kundalini, when that kundalini raises up through the spinal column, I should say, and it hits that area first, this is the area in which that helps with your dreams, your astral travels and projections and remote viewing and soul travels and so forth and so on. These sites are activated along with 12 other sites. These other 12 sites are known as the 12 paracranial nerves that sits around the pineal gland. This is where the concept of King Arthur and the 12 knights at the round table comes from, or Jesus at the last supper with his 12 disciples. The sun and his 12 zodiac signs, as above, so below, as within, so without. You get Rudolf Steiner. Now, Rudolf Steiner, he's the founder of the Anthroposophical Society, which is a branch off from the Theosophical Society, which is a branch off from the Rosicrucians. He states that the zodiacal nature is the microcosmically reflected in the skull. And this is true. These 12 cranial nerves sits around the pineal gland. The pineal gland is the master endocrine gland, and it's the center of the brain. So you have the olfactory nerve, the optic nerve, the oculomotor nerve, the trochlear nerve, the trigeminal nerve, the abyssinian nerve, the facial nerve, the vestibular nerve, the glossopharyngeal nerve, the vagus nerve, the accessory nerve, and the hypoglossal nerve. There's 12 pairs. Pair means two. So hence, 12 times 2 gives you 24. So this is metaphysically decoded in the Bible, in the Holy Bible, Revelations 4:4, in which that it states that around the throne was 24 seats, and upon the seat I saw 24 elders sit, clothed with white raiments, and they had on their heads crowns of gold. The 24 elders fell down before him that sat on the throne and worshiped him that lived forever and ever and cast their crowns before the throne. This is the soul embedded inside of the pineal gland. When he is awoken, he's now back on his throne. In ancient Kemetic teachings, Osset means throne, and Osor sits on Osset. She is the foundation. His rulership, his power, comes from Osset. Hence the Kundalini, when it raises up, it awakens the soul embedded in the pineal gland. It produces the resurrection. It rules the Christ within each and every one of us. The third category of the internal exercises is concerned with breathing techniques. Through these techniques, the energy can be absorbed through the crown, the top of the head, the acupuncture, acupressure points, which lays on top of the meridians, which transverse the body. Breathing is a vital step in the self-healing, and in forming an invisible link between the energy permeating the universe. So, we know that only through these three categories of internal exercises meet the dual requirements of preservation and transformation, hence reproduction and regeneration. We absorb via our breath, air, energy, prana, Ra, Chi, Ki, Holy Spirit, through the rays of the sun, the visible spectrum, Roy G. Biv. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. The same rainbow colors are the same colors on which that our chakras. The colors are emitted. So your foods on a daily basis should consist of these colors. For perfect balance, you must get at least an hour of sun a day as a melanated being. If you're a non-melanated being, then you need at least 20 minutes. for the melanated being needs an hour at least a day in the sun. We absorb energy through the water we drink. The best water is alkaline water. How we know? Because the best food is alkaline food. Alkaline food is electrical food. The best electrical food is raw food. Herbs are a must. One of the best herbs is dandelion. You can take dandelion on a daily basis. Why? Because it has all 12 nutritive blood, tissue, and muscle salts. When we talk about the various tissue salts, muscle salts, we break that down into the zodiac, in which that, for example, Aries need potassium phosphate. Taurus need sodium sulfate. Gemini need potassium chloride. Cancer needs calcium fluoride. Leo needs magnesium phosphate. Virgo needs potassium sulfate. Libra needs sodium phosphate. Scorpio needs calcium sulfate. Sagittarius needs silica. Capricorn needs calcium phosphate. Aquarius needs sodium chloride. And Pisces need iron phosphate. Now, I'm saying 12, even though we have to begin to start making adjustments to this calendar, or to the 12 zodiac signs in particular, because of Ephesus, which is the serpent wrestler coming in with the influence of Chiron, which is the wounded healer, in which they both are symbolic, actually, to the Kundalini. The serpent wrestler is nothing more than us wrestling with our serpent to awaken within each and every one of us, and it's situated between Sagittarius and Scorpio, which is Scorpio is over the genitalia, and Sagittarius is over the hips, pelvis, and smaller the back area, in which that these are the areas in which they be moved predominantly during the sexual experience in order to awaken the Kundalini. Ephesus is the Greco-Roman name. The name for Ephesus would be actually Imhotep, who lived during the Third Dynasty. So, dandelion has all 12 nutritive muscle blood salts, which that we just finished talking about, has all 12 of them. So if you're lacking in something, you can simply just eat dandelion. In this holistic perspective. All right. Dr. Alex Correll, he's a Nobel Prize winner. He concluded that all 76 trillion of our cells were originally immortal. The cell were immortal if it was not poisoned by polluted air, polluted water, and polluted food. We know we're being inundated with chemtrails. There's low ORP levels in the water. The water is too acidic in order to produce alkaline or alkalinity. pH balance of alkalinity for your physical body should be 7.4 if you're a male, 7.2 if you're a female. And then we have polluted food, which is GMOs, genetically modified organisms or genetically altered food. So fasting and detoxification is the key also to longevity. All right, we have a caller from 1-655. You're on the air. Yes, caller? Yes, caller?
Dr. Elaine Beck?
Yes.
How you doing? This is Shatan. I'm out of Raleigh, North Carolina. I just want to say some blessings to everything that you do, brother.
No, I appreciate that, brother. Thanks. Oh, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I just wanted to know, like, you know, I've been basically coming in my consciousness, you know, studying different brothers as far as you, Dr. Phil, Dr. Hammond, and Dr. John McClellan, just, you know, touching all branches to, you know, come with themselves in my consciousness. And I just wanted to know your opinion on as far as, like, my breathing or my chakras, because I started working on my chakras daily. And I wanted to know, like, what's your opinion, like, what would be the best thing for me to focus on as far as getting started with, like, my energy fields and my chakras as far as helping me in my physical and with my spiritual, so I can move forward as far as bringing it all together daily, so I can help me in my daily.
The most practical thing that you can do is just simply breathe, brother. You know, that's what activates your chakras, so there's nothing in which that you have to focus on as far as your chakras are concerned except for your breath.
Okay.
So we spoke about the pranic breathing, in which that you can do 100 times a day, and how it expands your auric fill. The pranic breathing consists of three different methods, two in particular. One is 7-1-7-1, which you will breathe in for a count of one, breathe in for a count of seven, hold it for one count, breathe out for a count of seven, and hold it for one count. So it would be like, as you breathe in, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold it for 1, 1, then out for 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold it for 1 again, and then repeat it over again 99 times, so it give you 100 times as you do. And what happens is that on your 100th time of doing it, it expands your auric field from normally 3 feet around you to 10 to 15 feet outside of your physical body. So you can also do that, or you can do the 6-3-6-3 breath technique, which you will breathe in for a count of 6, hold it for 3, breathe out for a count of 6, hold it for 3 again.
Okay. And do that 100 times also? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
I'm sorry, I said, would you do that with 100 times also?
Yes, all of it is 100 times daily.
Okay, yes, sir. Sounds good. And okay, brother, I just want to say.
Right.
Okay. So I can basically, you know, pick one and start with that one and do both of them, or how to do both of them, like, 100 times
you can do either or, brother. You can do either or, which one feels comfortable for you.
Okay.
Whichever one feels comfortable for you.
Okay. All right. I just want to say peace, brother. Thank you for the information. And is there any way that I can get information about your bookstore? Because I've been meaning to drive down to Fayetteville to come get some knowledge and stuff, but, you know,
Yes, our classes are every Friday at 7 p.m., the God Hour, at the store. It's called Cultural Freedom Bookstore, and we open on the weekends. Every Friday, particularly at 7 o'clock p.m., we have classes which we go into more extensive knowledge than I can go into the radio. We actually show you how to do the Qigongs, the breathing exercises, the Tai Chi, the Reiki, the pranic healing, all of these things are taught. The acupressure, the reflexology, I should say, itisology, all these things are taught there at the store / temple, because it is also known as the Moorish Holy Temple of Science of the world. And we also have healing classes online in which that we teach this information through WebEx, in which that you can actually the class is actually recorded, in which that we also do the PowerPoint presentation, as well as you can also see me through the webcam, and we do the exercises also on there too. Every Sunday and Tuesday at 7 p.m. So for those who are interested, now there's a contribution for these classes. classes, because these classes last 3 months, and you get certified in Reiki and Pranic Healing, in the various arts. You get certified. You get Reiki 1, 2, and 3. You get your Pranic Healing certificate, Herbology certificate, all of these things you get based on the information and was that you accumulate over the 3 months. All right. So for those who are interested, please email me at healingwingsonline@yahoo.com. That's healing, healing wings, wings, online, O-N-L-I-N-E, at yahoo.com. Healing Wings online at yahoo.com. All right? So that's what we have going on. For those who are sincere and really want to learn, want to master this information, come on into the classes. Come to the classes in Fayetteville. The Fayetteville classes are free. You don't ask for any monies. If you want to put forth a donation, then you can. But we've been doing these classes off and on for the last 20 years, free of charge. Okay?
All right, peace, brother. I thank you. Appreciate that. You got a good one, okay? And I'll make sure next week or so I'll be coming down to those. You said Friday at 7 o'clock, right?
Yes, Friday at 7 o'clock, every Friday.
All right, I'll see you soon, brother. Peace.
All right, peace, brother.
Hold up.
All right, do we have any other callers? Any other questions? All right, until I guess people can think of one, I guess we'll go back to the information. The information I was telling them about was what is called pranic breathing. I think I've gone over this before. However, what is also going on is the activation of those 12 meridians in which that we spoke about earlier. Normally, your lungs are activated between 3 a.m. to 5 a.m. in the morning, your large intestines between 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. in the morning, your stomach between 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. in the morning, your spleen between 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., your heart between 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., your small intestine between 1 p.m. to 3 p.m., your urinary tract and bladder is between 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. Your kidneys between 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Your pericardium between 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Your triple burner between 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Your gallbladder between 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. And your liver between 1 a.m. to 3 a.m. Now, if you feel pain in any of these areas while you're asleep or awoke, make sure you check the time and it's telling you that there's a blockage or some type of stagnated energy in which that is occurring in one of these particular organs at that time in which that you have felt that pain. All right? So what that breath does and what that we just made mention of is remove the blockages. All right? The 12 meridians are on the left and the right side of the body, and they're all connected with each other. So when one is affected by a blockage, they all can ultimately be damaged. All right, chi begins to flow into the lungs, then travels into the large intestines. From there, it goes into the stomach, then to the spleen, then it travels next to the heart, then to the small intestines. Next, it goes to the urinary bladder and the kidneys. After this, it heads towards the pericardium, and the triple burner, you know, finally it goes to the gallbladder, then the liver, then back to the lungs, where it starts its circulatory journey again. Assuming that your chi is flowing in a normal way and that you have no blockages, it travels through each of your organs at those specific times that I made mention of. Okay? Now, one of the breath techniques in which that helps correlate that, because you have to activate your Ida and your Pingala, which is at the base of the spine, which before you raise the Kundalini energy, you must activate the Ida and the Pingala. That is symbolic to our Set and Nebhet within the Kemetic teachings or Temerian teachings, all right, ancient Egyptian teachings, the Metu Netu. You have what is called the alternating nostril breath technique, what is called Anuloma Viloma, all right? This exercise, which is alternating nostril breath technique, optimizes the function between both sides of the brain, the left and the right hemisphere of the brain, your creativity and your logical, verbal side of your brain, all right? This leads to a balance between a person's creativity and logical thinking, all right? The yogis consider this to be the best technique to calm the mind and the nervous system, all right? So you can breathe, all right? You would close the right nostril, exhale through the left, and inhale to a count of four. Then you would close your left nostril as well and retain the breath to a count of 16. Then you will release the right nostril and exhale fully through for a count of eight. So 4, 16, 8. Then keeping the left nostril closed, inhale through the right to a count of four. Close both nostrils and retain the breath to a count of 16. And then release the left nostril and exhale to a count of eight. And you just completed one round. All right, we recommend that you do 36 of these daily. So you must get somewhere where you can have at least 45 minutes or an hour to yourself a day. If you can give the Al Beyond 8 hours of your time, of your life energy, you can at least give yourself 1 hour to recuperate. Because most of you do not wake up in the morning re-energized. But I give you a clue on how to do that. Lay on your right side and place your hand on your navel chakra and visualize yourself before you go to sleep that the energy is going as you breathe into your navel chakra, and you will wake up every morning re-energized, revitalized, rebooted, so you can be suited. All right? This is what you need to do for yourself. I can't do it for you, and this is why I'm not as respected as some of these other said metaphysicians, because I put the responsibility on you. I'm not putting them on no damn extraterrestrials outside of you. Who give a fuck? I'm not putting it off on the Illuminati. Who give a fuck? I don't. What I care about is you becoming God and Goddess. That's what I give a fuck about. Or this external shit, I don't care. Or that shit is nothing but a reflection that is being perpetrated and perpetuated on the masses. Because the masses are believing this shit. So they're trying to play out the Bible based on the perceptions that we have taken in. When if you was able to have this energy in which that we're talking about, we can recreate and reshape and remold this illusion and be the true magi, the true magicians in which that we need to be. I'm just tired of individuals making the masses of the people focus on things external, and they never make them focus on the internal processes of their own body. This is what needs to be done. Everything else is for naught. You be stressed out, worried, and hell, kill your damn self based on what you trying to see so much about outside of you. Instead, I'm trying to teach you the science of regeneration. This information, these teachings need to be upheld the most in civilization. This is the information which that you need to take in order to mold and shape the minds of your children. Teach them the science of regeneration. Teach them the science of longevity. Teach them the science of immortality. Let's move on. This is one of the ways to increase your healing energy. There are many techniques. Here's one such exercise. It's quite simple, but it takes about 2.5 minutes to do. You would sit upright, taking a deep breath to a count of five, slowly relax and let the air out for the count of 10, and then repeat this 10 times consecutively. Now, while you're doing that, as you're breathing in, you want to make sure that your hand is in a fist, clenched, both hands, left and right, and your jaw, your teeth are together, and your tongue is at the roof of the mouth, right behind the teeth to close off the circuit. And also, you can pull up your anal muscles, which is called the D exercise or the Kegel exercise or whatever term that you want to refer to it as, and pull up that area. It is also, you can also pull up your perineum. All of that is pulled up. So what you have done with the tongue behind the teeth at the upper palate and pulling up of the anal muscles and perineum, you have closed off the circuit from energy being letting energy escape from your body. And the fact that your hand is clenched shows forth that you are actually controlling the energy. You're moving ethereal energy. So as you breathe in, you're settling the energy into your navel chakra. Some refer to it as the Dantian, the lower heaven. Some say it's about 1 to 3 inches below that. If you fill up your navel chakra, it will expand to 3 inches below, but it is only your navel chakra. All right. Now, if you do that exercise even longer, for 15 to 20 minutes, you will find a noticeable stimulation and a noticeable difference. So once again, your back is straight, your feet at a feet shoulder width apart, feet are on the floor evenly. You will take in a breath of five, let out the air for a count of 10, and you will repeat that 10 times consecutively. You can do it up to 15 to 20 minutes. And what that does is increase your healing energy. And we probably need that because, I know I do, because, you know, we just finished going through an episode about individuals who take everything in which that is so much external and never focus on the internal. And that really disturbs me. And the fact is that a lot of these so-called metaphysicians are not teaching this information to you. They're still doing lectures on the Illuminati. On the chemtrails. On the heart, Yes, teach these things, but also teach them how to combat it with their own electromagnetic field, with their own power. We must do this. All right, we have another caller. Another question. Brother, you have a question? Caller, you're on the air. You have a question? Caller, 1-655. Okay, his hand is up, but obviously he's not on the air here. Okay, I guess we'll come back. But these are the sciences of alternative healing, in particular Reiki, Qigong. We'll get into pranayama, which is actually pranic healing, as is moderately called today. Pranic healing, prana, once again, is universal life force energy. Qi is universal life force energy. Reiki is universal life force energy, all symbolic to the same energy, just different methods on how to use this same energy. In pranayama, that is actually called breath control, or mastering the breath, the science of breath as it is. Matter of fact, there's a book called The Science of Breath in which that I recommend that you get it. Also, The Science of Pranayama, I recommend you get. The Science of Breath is written by Yoga Ramachakra, and Science of Pranayama, which I can't remember right now, is written by one of the yogis also. Yogi Sadananda, if I'm not mistaken. But these two books is a must, and I think you can download these two books actually in PDF form right offline for free. So after you get off from here, go and download these books if you don't already have them and begin to start practicing some of these techniques, some of these breath techniques in this book, in these books. Another good book to get is my teacher's book, always, is Jewel in the Lotus. He teaches the science of pranayama, the way it affects the body, and how to even use that energy during a sexual experience, or either during your own episode of masturbation. How to raise that energy up, how to do a micro and macrocosmic orbit, how to regenerate yourself with your own bodily energy. You can also go to his website, www.shindao. Shindao Monastery.com or Shindao Energy Arts.com. But if you put it into the engine search, or if you put his name into the engine search, Sunyata Saraswati, and that's Sunyata, Sunyata, and then Saraswati, Saraswati. I recommend you get up with him and get initiated into the various Cobra Breath techniques. There's four of them that he can take you through, three in which that the masters, the ascended masters will take you through, in particular Baba G will take you through, which are the other three, which would be seven. So, begin to master this science. You have to. Now, in pranic healing, there's certain things in which that you must learn the science of, One is scanning, and how you scan, you would scan the inner and the outer aura of the individual. So the outer aura extends, like we said earlier, 3 feet from outside of the physical body. The inner aura about 2 inches above the physical body, which actually is your ethereal body. The one that extends out to 3 feet is your astral body. You would scan for holes, leaks. And how you know there's holes or leaks is because you would feel air. You also feel for heat, cold. And actually, we distribute heat to the cold areas and vice versa. And you can do the scanning to an individual who is there in your presence, or you can actually do it with a picture, or you can do it mentally with the mind, the power of imagination and visualization. This is where it connects with Reiki at, with the Hanshoshishonin symbol of distant healing. The individual do not have to be in front of you, and you can actually project energy to them in the various colors onto them. The various colors are the colors of the Roy G. Biv, of the rainbow, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. The second part of the scanning, or the second after scanning is one, two would be sweeping. And the sweeping will actually take your hands. You would take your hands and start at the top of the head and go down the right side of the body, down to the feet, and then work your way to the left side of the body, down to the feet. And you would actually rake out the debris, the negative debris, in which it has become congested within the auric field. And make sure you have a pot of a potted plant, water, or sand, a bowl of water or a pail of sand, so that you can flick your hands 3 times hard after each time you come down from the top to the feet, down to the bottom of the feet. And you can actually flick that negative energy off into the pot or pan or plant. After you are done, you can then do what is called energize the body. And you can actually project the energy into the specific area in which that the person is dealing with, or you can actually project the energy over the whole body. I suggest you do the whole body first and then concentrate on the localization, the local area of the hurt or the pain, after you do the whole body treatment with energizing. Make sure you have another bowl of water afterwards. And you're going to stabilize the energy by your thoughts, your intention of saying that you want to lead this energy into this area in order to heal that individual. Once that is done, you have finished the process. You can go and wash your hands up to the elbows to make sure that there's not any residue of energy from the individual, because that is a shamanistic healing or shaman healing aspect or technique in which that you have done, and you don't want to transfer the symptoms from the individual to yourself. So you wash your hands up to your elbows to make sure that there is no transference in cold water. Now, of course, before you wash your hands, you want to take the plant, put it back where it was, or either take the water or the sand that was in the pail or in the bowl and throw it outside. And then, of course, you can wash your hands and do what you need to do for yourself. And ask the individual how they feel afterwards. you know, give them the exercises in order to do the Reiki hand positions, which we went over earlier. They can also do the sweeping on their own body from head to toe, or have someone else to do it as they give the instructions, and that can be done 3 times a day. And their body will readjust to the healing effect. Their organs will readjust. Their glands will readjust. Their chemical response will readjust. Their mental response will readjust. Remember, we went over last week that every chemical response is a messenger, a message code, in which that is being released via the mind, from the mind via the brain, I should say. So a chemical response within the body, a thought within the body produces a chemical response, a message code, in which that is transferred to the cells, all 76 trillion of them. This is why I can take a speck of blood, a drop of spittle, a strand of hair, a flake of skin, and clone a whole nother you into existence. With the very thoughts of you from out of the womb to that point of origin. At least with the tendencies of the first incarnation. So that means that your actual body is an apparent solid. According to Ageless Body, Timeless Mind by Deepak Chopra, he states in there that 99.9999% of your atom, of your atomic body, or your atomic body is empty. And only one, 0.0001% of your atomic body is actually solid, or apparently solid. That means this potential energy can be transformed into kinetic energy, and it's through the power of thought, through tapping into infinite consciousness. We spoke about the 7 states of consciousness: interpersonal consciousness, intrapersonal consciousness, life consciousness, subconsciousness, superconsciousness, magnetic consciousness, and infinite consciousness, the 7 states of consciousness. These 7 states of consciousness is based on the 7 prophets of the Bible, because it's all based on the 7 chakra system, the 7 churches. The root chakra is Adam, made from the dust of the ground. The serpent in the Garden of Eden, the serpent is the Kundalini, now that dwells in the root chakra. Also, the clitoris and the penis is a physical representation of that serpent itself. The navel chakra, that's Noah. It rained 40 days and 40 nights on his ark. That is symbolic to the shape of the navel chakra, as well as also in Qigong, Tai Chi, we flood that energy, or we flood that space or that area, that chakra, with energy. Symbolically, the waters of life. Next is the solar plexus. As Abraham, he came from the land of Ur. Ur means Chaldea, means fire. Ur means fire. That's what that means. As a matter of fact, Chaldees means demon, because that is part of your 4 devils, as the Nation of Gods on Earth say within their 120 in the Justice Lesson of 1 through 14. Why must Muhammad and any Muslim murder the devil? They're referred to as the four devils. These four lower chakras. The three higher chakras are your trinity. Let's continue on. You have your heart chakra, which is symbolic to David. The word David in Hebrew means beloved. What you do with your heart, you love. Next is the throat, which is symbolic to Moses. Moses couldn't speak adequately, so supposedly Moses needed his brother to do the speaking for him. But you no longer see his brother in the book of Exodus. You only see him speaking before the Pharaoh, talking about let my people go. So Moses symbolized expression. And then it says that God transformed Moses into an Elohim, into a God. So that means that that was the beginning stage of the three higher chakras. But Moses wasn't able to, he was given a glimpse into paradise, but he was not able to go into the land of Canaan, as they would say, the land of milk and honey. Same with David. David wasn't given the ability in order to form the temple of God. Of course, he was a murderer. Hatred is a murderer of your true desires, of the things in which that you need to do upon planet Earth. It clogs the heart. Same thing with Moses. He was a murderer. But yet he was transformed into an Elohim. The reason why, because he was protecting a slave, or a Hebrew slave, as they would say, from two Egyptians. And Moses supposedly killed them. David, on the other hand, killed Bathsheba's husband. So that was done out of greed, lust, envy. Moses wasn't. His was done out of necessity to save a Hebrew slave, as they would say. All of this is allegorical, but they have metaphysical properties and principles and implications that we have to pay attention to. Next is the third eye. That's the seat of Christ. Jesus, the light of the world. That is symbolic to the area in which that you see on the crown or the tiaras or the crowns of the empress and the emperor, or the Nagu, the Naga, or the Neges, whatever term that you want to call, Pharaoh, you see the serpent right there at the third eye area. Jesus said, "Be yet gentle as a dove. Gentle as a dove. Think how it goes. It says something about be ye wise as a serpent. Be yet gentle as a dove." So the serpent was a symbol of Jesus, the Christ. That is the resurrected Asetian energy. The Kundalini, to the pineal gland, to the third eye area, that beams off from the pituitary gland, the queen of the kingdom, to the king of the kingdom, which is the pineal gland. That's the beginning of the marriage in heaven. The crown, the top of the head, is Muhammad. Hence the reason why they say within Islam that Muhammad is the last of the prophets. He's the last seal of the prophets. There's seven seals. And he's the last seal of them. So we done went through the three monotheistic belief systems. Went through the Old Testament, which is the Torah, or the Pentateuch, which the Jews use. We went through Christianity, the New Testament, and then we went into Islam, the Holy Quran. And that is showed forth through the various prophets in which they have chosen, in order to emulate those seven churches or seven chakras in which we're talking about. All right? Are there any questions Any questions? Let me see. Go to the chat room. Alright, any questions? Come on, any questions? Alright. Alright, got questions from 3801. You're on the air.
Yes, hello.
Yes, greetings, peace.
Yes, greetings to you. I just recently tuned into your show. Basically, my question is regarding, goodness, I just about you saying, about were you quoting, be wise or be aware of the serpent and gentle to the dove?
Right. That's the masters.
Mm-hmm. Could you explain a little bit more?
Right. Well, in the book of Matthew, it specifically states that Jesus said to his disciples to be wise as a serpent, but yet gentle as a dove. So a serpent was symbolic to wisdom because it sheds its skin. Just like the soul sheds the skin of the physical body. When the snake shed its skin, it's a form of regeneration or renewal. It's the same with the soul. When the soul has worn out the physical body, the communication between the soul and the body is no longer necessary or useful. It no longer exists. So the soul sheds that body, possibly to be incarnated again, or to be as an ascended master to help from the astral plane. So that is the symbology between the serpent and the soul itself. It's based on what happens with the serpent, not necessarily
thank you,
what
thank
the serpent.
Mm-hmm. Right. Thank you for clarification. Are you familiar with Irish moss? It's a sea moss.
Yes, sea moss. Yes. Mhm. Matter of fact, I got some right here next to me.
Excuse me. I didn't hear that. Excuse me.
Say it again.
No, I asked you if you were familiar with Irish moss, sea moss.
Yes, I am. I have some right next to me. Mm-hmm. See most? Yeah.
You have some right next to you?
Yes,
oh,
I do.
So it's something that you use on a regular basis?
Yes, I do, every day.
Oh, I recently purchased some in the powder form.
Right. That's how mine is right now.
You got it from New York?
No, I get mine from Star West Botanicals.
Oh, yes, yeah, Star West. They're
yes.
I think they're always Sacramento, I think.
Yes, mine is organic. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Small world. Okay. I've been using the Irish moss, and it's really good for the thyroid gland, and it has a whole host of things that it's really good for the body. The iron levels. I was previously anemic, but now because of the Irish moss, it definitely balanced up my body, and I'm no longer anemic.
Exactly.
But not too many people are familiar with Irish moss, unless they have like a Caribbean background.
Right. And if they go to any Jamaican spot, they can. Jamaicans normally sell, if it's a Jamaican store, they normally sell the Irish sea moss there in its natural form, and then you can actually take it home, soak it, boil it, make sure you have a top on it so it won't lose the enzymes, and actually return to a gel. And you can actually put it in a blender and actually, you know, put it within your drinks, such as your carrot juice or, you know, your other juice blends, you know, and drink it that way also.
Have you written any books or?
Oh, yes, I've written several books. The book which I've written is Out of the Womb, Into the Mind, as well as also The First World Order. Those are the two books in which that we currently have out right now, and we're in the process of writing about three or four more, actually.
Oh, okay. I was wondering if you could okay, that's very interesting. I'm actually a writer who is looking to, you know, associate with someone who has different concepts so I can, you know, possibly edit the book or help them, you know, with the project. I'm also a writer and a publicist. I work with a lot of different, a lot of entertainers within the music industry, such as Brian McKnight and Big Pun. I was a celebrity entertainment journalist, and I wrote for different magazines, such as Essence and Blackbeat Magazine and a host of others, and then I branched out into publicity. So I don't know if it's possible if you can take down my information.
Oh, yes. Do me a favor. Email me at healingwingsonline@yahoo.com. That's
H-E-A-L,
healingwingsonline@yahoo.com. H-E-A-L-I-N-G, wings, online, O-N-L-I-N-E, @yahoo.com.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Healing Wings.
Yes, Healing Wings online at Yahoo.
Online at Yahoo.com.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much for the information.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you.
All right, have a good night.
All right, you too now.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Now, I want to make sure that those in the chat room, can y'all still hear me? Because there's some questions in which I need to answer in the chat room. One is talking about how this breathing works with our melanin. So before I can move on to that, I want to make sure that everybody is in the chat room. Can y'all, are y'all able to hear me? Please, somebody write or text that into the chat, please. Can you all hear me? All right, it looks like they can't hear me in the chat room. So what we're going to do is end the show, and I thank each and everyone for all right, I'm going to end the show, and I thank you all for checking us out, and we'll be back here again next Wednesday at 8 o'clock. All right. It seems like y'all can hear me in the chat room, so I'm going to answer this question before we go. To activate our melanin is through the science of breathing. Our breath and melanin are directly connected. All right. Remember, your skin breathes. It has pores. Your skin is known as the second lungs. And being that it's on your skeletal system, covering your blood supply, covering your plasma, chemicals, and so forth and so on, your skin is very important, and it's through the science of breathing. Matter of fact, there's a technique in which that you can actually do, which is called pore breathing, through your skin, or skin pore breathing. And you can do that by breathing in, doing one of the pranic breathing or pranic breath techniques that we said, 6-3-6-3, and visualize the energy coming in from out into your whole being, your whole skin, your whole flesh. All right, and then releasing the toxins on the exhale. And you can actually do as you inhale through your nose, and then as you exhale, open your mouth and exhale the toxins. So that is also one way in order to do it. And we're going to end the show. We thank y'all once again for chilling with us. Come back next week. All right, peace.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air. No doubt.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Burn. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Burn. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. Burn. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics.
Radio.
Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.